Hi, I'm Gordon Cooper. I'm a product marketing manager here at Synopsys. I'm responsible for BetaVision processor IP and neural network IP. Today, we're going to talk about super resolution. Now, Kyocera recently announced a new product, the Task Alpha 3554 CI multifunction printer. It's enabled by Synopsys and BetaVision processor IP, and that allows for some amazing new artificial intelligence features for the customers. Probably my favorite feature is super resolution. It's the ability to take a low resolution image and upscale it to a high resolution image. But how is that done? We've also often seen low resolution images that if you expand, they just look pixelated. In fact, probably one of the worst TV tropes out there is when the detective goes into the technician and says, "Can you enhance this image?" And the technician hits a few keys and voila, high resolution image. But the problem is it doesn't work that way. The data is gone. There's no way to recover the data in a low resolution image to kind of reinsert it to recover that high resolution image. At least that was the case until deep learning. With a deep learning neural network, it is trained, not programmed. And in the process of training, you're inserting more data in and it can be used to kind of fill in the gaps. So there's a bunch of super resolution neural networks out there. SRGAN is an example. And they actually do this sort of magical reinsert the data where you really can go from a low resolution image, maybe four times scaling up to a high resolution image. Now, the challenge of implementing this is super resolution algorithms take a lot of computations. They take a lot of data flow. If you're not doing this real time, no problem. Just let a CPU or GPU crunch away at it. But if you have a certain frame rate requirement, or you have some real-time limitations, then you're going to need a dedicated neural network processor. So we here at Synopsys have the EV7X family with a scalable DNN solution. You can scale from 880 max to high resolution. If you're looking to implement super resolution, you're going to need to know the input resolution, the output resolution, any bandwidth limitations. Maybe you have one LPDDR4, for example, in the system, maybe you have multiple. And then you're going to need to know your frame rate targets. And then we can help figure out which of the EV7X processors with their DNN options is right for you. So super resolution is this great new feature. It's actually been around for a few years, but really sort of implemented recently in customer designs that we see, that you can actually really upscale a low resolution image to a high resolution image and really see great quality there. If you want more information about our BetaVision processors, go to synopsys.com/EV. Thanks for listening.